Hi, people, we back with another game show answers. Last time it did really well. People seemed to really enjoy it. So myself, I'm big old Randy.
Back.
Do you like being called Randy?
Yes.
Actually.
That's actually where Randolph came from, was my friends at school called me Randy. So that's why Randolph exists.
I don't know if you liked it though.
No, I love it, yeah. Randy's my, I like it.
Okay.
Yeah, and Laura used to call me Randy, but now she doesn't. She calls me Andrew. So, boo. You get added, put a boo in.
Hi, right, well, I'm back with Randy, and we are going to be guessing more game show answers. If you haven't seen the last one, feel free to go watch that.
It's jokes.
Yeah, I can't bother to explain it.
This one's already going to be funny because the guy's name is Eric. just the way his hair is like slicked down, I know he's going to say some dumb shit. If you're watching this and your name is Eric,
or you have slicked down hair,
I'm sorry.
He looks like Schweinsteiger.
Before we get into the video, check out Simon Clothing.
I mean, yeah.
He paid me to say that.
Alright, here we go. We're gonna keep score. The winner gets this book of foreign swear words.
Ooh, can I try one out? It's a big book. Wait, it says a little book, but
it's a very little book.
How many swear words are there? To a poor comma, uncool this singer. You smell like a monkey's ass.
Was that French?
Yeah.
Where was your accent?
To poor comma, under singer.
You sounded like Nigerian or something.
Who did you? Do I like his white iron farsh?
The putz. It's Chris.
That's a good French accent.
That was ropey old slag. Okay, we're losing focus. All right, first one.
Tell me a part of the body that begins with the letter T.
Who made this? Why is an option tungsten carbide?
Isn't tungsten an element?
So the only thing here that is a part of your body is titties.
Yeah. Which one do you think?
I think we'll say titties.
I'm going tiger.
All right, all right.
Tell me a part of the body that begins with the letter T.
Titties.
Alright, you're 1-0 up.
1-0, right? I'll remember that, don't you worry.
You know that he's seen a lot of titties in his life.
Yeah,
No, not you, Eric.
What type of vehicles are used to compete in the legendary Tour de France?
You know the answer.
Cycles.
Yeah, okay. Bicycles. Cycles look like both. Tugboats.
I think you're right, but I'm gonna go with baguettes.
You're going with baguettes.
Because if you do it, this guy's a legend.
Why?
Because he's just gone France, baguette.
All right, players, tell me what type of vehicles are used to compete in the legendary Tour de France. Alan again.
SUVs.
We were both wrong.
Name a kind of bear.
Oh, here we go. A type of bear.
Ooh.
I think Papa Bear.
I think cartoon.
Really?
Yeah, it's like type of bear. I think all they can think of is bear or cartoon bear. So I'm going now. I'm going all out.
Okay, you're going cartoon, I'm going Papa.
Yep, yep.
Name a kind of bear. Harmon.
Papa Bear.
A Papa Bear.
Yes!
I love how this
name something a male dog Ooh. Might give to a female dog he likes.
His bone. I was literally like, his bone. In my head, I went, his bone, before the answers came up.
Himself. Rough. Again, I'm going with that one. I'm just hoping that, you know, comedy prevails.
Name something a male dog
so
might
clean.
Give to a
yeah.
female
HD.
Dog he likes. Joey?
I don't know how to phrase this. Himself. Rough.
Yeah! Oh my god! Look at him!
Himself. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Make love. Doggy love.
Why did he look at her?
Doggy style?
You're making it. Stop! Stop him!
Even he was like, yes,
please, Steve. I've just looked at this woman and gone, doggy style, rough.
Yeah.
And he hit the mouth, so he went, himself,
rough.
All right, next one.
I can't believe I got that right.
So you got that right, you're 2-1 up.
2-0.
2-1?
You didn't get any.
No.
Go back and check. Look.
I'm willing to bet you a point.
Harmon.
Papa Bear.
A Papa Bear.
Yes! 2-0, bish!
Oh my, yeah, 2-0.
Christy, in UK geography, the road called Watling Street that now forms part of the A5 was originally built by which civilization?
Oh my god. That question was just...
So fast, so that many
was,
words.
I know, I hate whenever Anne. What's her name? Anne.
Umbilical cord. Umbilical cord.
Her name is not umbilical cord.
Anne Whittacombe.
That's not Anne Robinson!
Oh yeah.
Why are we looking at Anne? Alright, what are we going for? It was built by Wapping Street, basically. It was built by what civilization? Apes.
I'm going to say the 12 Disciples. No. I'm going for the craziest ones and then hoping I'll win by the end of it. Baby Boomers is one, is what she'll say. So if you want a 3 point...
No, I'm going apes.
Baby Boomers. Okay, I'm going to change to Baby Boomers then.
Okay.
Christy, in UK geography, the road called Watling Street that now forms part of the A5 was originally built by which civilization?
Apes.
Boom!
Romans.
Boom! If you want a 3 point, go for...
I'm sorry, but that's so stupid.
That's the point of this game!
How could apes build a street? It's like saying apes built Abbey Road, like...
Maybe they did.
No, they didn't.
Did Baby Boomers build it?
Probably. Yeah. Like, apes can't build streets.
I'm winning! 3-2!
Reason you might stay indoors on a beautiful day.
Wow. Yo, he was as quick as I was.
Daddy!
No clean underwear.
I was looking at that. I think I might go with You Lost Your Keys. It's Raining is too obvious.
Yeah.
And that would be right, surely.
Reason you might stay indoors on a beautiful day.
Because it's raining?
Oh, no, I actually just got... No, I got my dumb answer.
What was the question?
Reason you might stay indoors on a beautiful day. It's on a beautiful day. Beautiful day. Beautiful...
Right, okay.
We missed that little part.
Yeah, we did.
We missed the sunny day part. Oh, we are idiots.
I think we're idiots.
Police commissioner said, I think Batman and Robin are blank.
I think goths.
I'm going to say queer.
Yeah?
I think it's a real police commissioner, and he thought they were a real thing back in the day, and now they're dead. So I'm changing my answer from C to A, which is deaf.
I'm going
to
go with goths. I feel like goths is weird enough.
Yeah, it is.
I think Batman and Robin are blank.
Queer.
You could have got a point. You could have got... What's the score?
3-3.
One of the three bears.
One of the three bears.
C, Goldilocks.
Yogi.
Yogi's correct. No, I've thought about it.
You can change your answer. We can go for the same answer.
I'm going Goldilocks.
Yeah?
It's 3-all.
Okay, 3-all.
If correct, it's just 4-all. I want to get over you.
All right.
Nope. Nah.
I mean, it's better than you want to get under me.
I don't want either.
One of the three bears.
Yogi.
You know what? I think I've seen that. I've seen that clip of him going Yogi. I'm not going to accept that. I'll count that as when we bet.
Okay, yeah,
we'll
okay.
We'll scratch it. So it's 3-all. It's 3-all now.
What was the answer? It's like polar bear.
What? One of the three bears. Goldilocks and the three bears.
Name something you hope doesn't fall apart while you're on it.
Something that doesn't fall apart while you're on it. Oh, when you're on it!
Yeah, yeah.
I heard when yawning.
While you're on it.
Why would anything fall apart when you yawn?
You yawn, your wife disintegrates.
You're on the toilet.
I think it's going to go with the obvious choice, the toilet. I want to say wife.
I'm going to go wife.
Name something you hope doesn't fall apart while you're on it.
My wife.
Big up, Jack.
Why am I not going with my gut, man?
Yeah, 4-3.
When a man falls out of your boat and into the water, you should yell, man overboard. Now, what should you yell if a woman falls overboard?
He was going to say full speed ahead. I'm going with my big fat gut this time.
I'm going with don't look back.
It's an old clip. This guy, yeah, he's going to fully say full speed ahead.
Don't look back.
Okay.
When a man falls out of your boat and into the water, you should yell, man overboard.
No, you're right.
Now, what should you yell if a woman falls overboard?
Full speed ahead.
Look at his speed, he said that as well.
To be fair though, I think he was going to change his answer before everyone calls him sexist. It looked like he was about to say something.
Yeah.
He's about to say something else.
If the Statue of Liberty were a man, what might it be holding instead of a toy?
A wang. It's wang. So instead of this, it's just like...
I think he's going to say it's wang. He's going to answer it so quick as well. He's going to be like, it's wang.
I think you're right. You know what though? I'm going to go with... No. We'll go different answers.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with... It's middle finger.
If the Statue of Liberty were a man, what might it be holding instead of a torch?
Yeah. Oh my God! And it was right!
He said something. But I don't get it because...
Yeah.
British traffic lights are green, amber, and which other colour?
Oh my God.
Oh, okay.
Stop. 100% stop. If you think it's stop as well, go stop.
Okay, I'm good.
If you want to go stop though, this one, it's 100% stop.
Yeah, it is. Okay, stop, okay.
We both know what colour.
I'm going to go cyan, just in case it's not. Because when I was
cyan.
Cyan.
Wait, so you're going cyan? You're not going for stop?
I've said cyan all my life, is it wrong?
I think it's cyan.
Okay, cyan. I'm going cyan.
Rinna, in travel, British traffic lights are green, amber, and which other colour?
Green.
Red.
Oh my god. Oh my god, she's so dumb. Oh my god. I want to see the reaction.
I know, I do.
Green, amber, and green.
Name something you wouldn't want the police to find in the trunk of your car.
Okay. What would you, what would you not want them to find?
I'm going to a pot of gold.
Then I'm going to go with a bear.
Imagine the pickles. Like, oh, excuse me, sir. Why are you pickles in your car?
They weren't pickles, they're cucumbers.
Yeah. Maybe, like, in his state, pickles are banned. I don't know.
What kind of state is that? Actually, it's America.
Yeah, who knows?
Name something you wouldn't want the police to find in the trunk of your car.
Pickles.
You see how they all applauded him?
Yeah.
See how they... Great answer! I'm gonna go with mustard!
We need to not underestimate how stupid these answers are.
Alright, Marley.
Marley's on it. Come
on. This is gonna be a big one.
Yeah. Well, who's your first?
I'm first, and it's still 4-3.
Jeez, to me.
Yeah.
You talk to 100 married women. What does your husband do when he runs out of clean underwear?
I'm gonna go with B.
Crazy stunt behaves.
Trying to do the accent.
Trying to do American.
Crazy stunt behaves. Yeah. You don't know where she's from. She hasn't spoken yet.
She's American.
There's different accents in America.
True.
Which one do you go? I'm going with praise his stomach behaves.
He never wears them.
He never wears them.
A.
He's going with A.
I'm sticking with A.
I was like very between B and C.
We talked to 100 married women. What does your husband do when he runs out of clean underwear?
He wears a pair of mine.
Oh my god, you got it right.
I also got the accent right.
He wears a pair of mine.
He's like, nah, dude.
Steve, honestly, I don't. I don't do that. He's got my G-string on my hand.
And ask them to name a way of toasting someone.
And then toast.
You've been toasted.
Yeah, I'm going 5 minutes on each side.
Okay, I'm going over a fire.
Okay, and it's going to be A. I know it is.
No, I need to pull this back over a fire.
Yeah, you do.
I made 100 people and asked them to name a way of toasting someone. Michelle.
Over a fire.
Boom! Boom! I'm back!
Something you wouldn't try even once.
It's you to go first.
Mustard on rice. Something you wouldn't try once. I'd try that once.
I'd try it once, yeah.
Ping pong.
No.
You know what? Ping pong.
I'm gonna go sex on a train.
What should be if it's mustard on rice, their mind works in a different way.
Yes, like, it's because you know she's been curious about it as well. Yeah. I wonder what that tastes like. Oh, I've never tried it though.
And they're like, what would you never try? Mustard on rice? Yes. I was just thinking this.
To name something you wouldn't try even once.
Matthew.
Sex on a train.
No! Six more!
Name a word that rhymes with the nurse.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Let me go first. Me.
I'm 100% going doctor.
Okay. Oh yeah. Yeah.
Wait, why me?
Not you.
No, why me?
I don't know, his name is gonna be something like that.
Oh, you think his name's gonna rhyme with nurse? Like, he's gonna go me.
Name a word that rhymes with the nurse.
You got this.
Church! I mean, it doesn't really rhyme.
No, but I would put it in a song.
You could half rhyme it.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
I mean, when it's you're there, like, word. Nurse. What rhymes with nurse? You're gonna go purse, curse, purse.
Yeah. Verse.
Church! Ours were funnier answers, though.
I know. I love it if you said me. Like,
what rhymes with nurse? Me.
Name something you need to have if you bought a pet elephant.
A hot tub. Is that accent 100%?
Yeah.
when you know it's a dumb answer, you know it's going to be that. Yeah, I don't want to say.
I don't know why, but...
It's going to be that, a hot tub.
Yeah.
It's a mouse.
See, like in England, like people from the south are always like, oh, you're posh. And people from the north are just poor. But in America, the south is just...
That's a stereotype, though. That's not him saying it.
Oh, yeah. That's stereotype. And I feel like in America, people will always say that the southern are just dumb. Which is obviously not true.
I'm going to go with a car wash.
That's what I was going to go with.
I mean, we haven't been getting it right, so maybe it's
a mouse. A mouse.
Yeah, with the mouse?
Yeah, it's weird.
Name something you need to have if you bought a pet elephant.
I'm going to say you would probably need to have a car wash.
Yeah, she didn't have the accent, I thought.
No, she didn't.
All right, 6-5.
We asked 100 people to name a game you can play in bed.
I hope it's not tag. You're lying in bed next to each other.
Tag.
You know the rule as well, you're like, no tags in backseats.
Yeah.
Tag, no tags in backseats. Smell it.
Yeah. All right, John, I've lost again. I spy.
I'm going to go with tag.
All right, it's going to be checkers. Like, we keep getting it wrong.
We asked 100 people to name a game you can play in bed.
Steve.
I spy.
Woo!
Name something normally worn only by children.
Go with clothes. 100%. Yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
It has to be.
I'm gonna go with Band-Aids.
I have to get, if I didn't get this right, I think I might have lost.
Yeah. I think you got it right as well.
Name something normally worn only by children.
What?
Michael.
Clothes.
God. Last one.
Oh shit.
You're winning by one. So if I get this, you get to go first. So if I get this right, because we had that bet earlier and I took that point away.
Yeah.
If I get it right, I win.
Yeah.
If you get it right, you win.
Yeah.
But if we both get it wrong, you win.
Okay, yeah. Okay. That's fair.
Name a job that's dirty, but someone has to do it.
A plumber.
Try again.
Okay, so he's not dumb.
No.
Because you went with a plumber.
I'm gonna go stripper. Because I wish it is.
Okay, I'm gonna go with bikini waxer. So right now, this is it. The final moment of the video. The winner of the book.
So I want stripper or gynecologist.
You just don't want bikini waxer.
Yeah, okay.
Come on, please.
Name a job that's dirty, but someone has to do it.
A plumber.
Try again.
Of course. Dirty. Gynecologist.
No! You win!
Yeah!
We both got it wrong.
I couldn't remember who won.
Sure, whatever. Anyways, that's it for today. Randolph wins this. If you want to see another one, let us know in the comments down below. We are filming a video over on his channel. He's going to teach me how to make a beat.
Woo!
So check that out over on his channel. It's probably already out, to be honest.
Yeah.
I don't know when this is out.
Yeah.
So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and peace.